Once again, good afternoon, friends, students. That means in previous lecture, I discussed the points related to the reproduction of a story, which is considered one. And here, in that point, from the poem, we have to rewrite the story. That is the reproduce the story. We discussed one, even though I shared the hints for that thing. Today, that means in this lecture, we are going to discuss the letter writing. This thing, letter writing, this point, because in your school time also, or even you can say that letter writing, this concept you know already, because your high school or in your 11th or 12th standard duration, during that particular your education, you already studied this particular point, letter writing. And this letter writing, it is considered for all languages. That may be Marathi, that may be Hindi, and that may be English. So you already know this particular thing. But as per the syllabus point of view, I have to again discuss with you people how to write the letter. Right. Here it is said that every educated person should know how to write the letter. Not only to write the letter, he has to know how to write the clear and readable letter. See the point, what they are given here, clear and readable letter. And letters can be written for, by the business people, by the professional people, by any educated person, for the n number of things. That may be application, in the form of application, that may be invitation for this friends or relatives, that may be that any kind of a thing, it is considered one. And for that, you have to write the letter in a clear and readable form. That's why it is said here. And so, to write the proper letter, we have to consider some points, some things, some form of a letters we have to understand one. Then only we will get the exactly how to write that particular letter, or what exactly form of that particular letter is there. We have to understand thing. Okay. Exactly the form of letter. That means in which manner we are going to write the letter. What is the exactly the key concept it is considered to write the letter. That is a form of a letter. Because that letter may be written, that means for any persons, any things, to clear any points, to do the request, to invite, some sort of the things it is considered for the business point of view. Okay, different, and by considering that, there are different kinds of letters are there. Such a letters are friendly letters, business letters, application letters like that, right? Invitation letters like that, it is there. So here some key points or key things are there. Some additional hints it is considered, or some regular hints it is considered for the writing the letter. So it is having so 6 main points. I'll explain you how the write the that means how the letter should be formed one, or letter should be written one. The letter, it should be contained mainly 6 points, having the heading. First is the heading, having the heading. And that heading, which is consist of, letter should be considered the heading. That heading should be consist the address of the writer and date. Date, it is considered for the reference purpose, on which date he is written that particular letter. Right, for that purpose it is the date it is considered. Then second point is the courteous greeting or salutation. That is that point it is considered one. Then third one is the exactly what you want to write. That means communication or message. It is called as a communication, a message. Then fourth point is the subscription or courteous leave or leave taking. Courteous leave taking. Or you can say that it is a conclusion that you have to consider. Then the signature. And then last one is the sixth point is the superscription, superscription on the envelope. Superscription on the envelope. So we'll see one by one these things. Right. See here. First is the heading. Second is the exactly salutation, which is considered one courteous of that particular. Right. Then the courtesy of greeting, it is called as. Then the communication or that message, that means exactly the body we are seeing that thing. Then subscription, or you can see that conclusion. Then the signature, who is writing that particular letter, right? In that he has to mention in the signature. Then the superscription of the letter on the envelope. Superscription on the envelope. These 6 points should be considered here. Right. One by one we will see that. The heading, first point is the heading. The heading, it informs to the reader from where the letter it is wrote by. Who is the writer is there. That information it is considered one. And on which date it is written one. That information it is considered in the heading. And that date it is written for the reference purpose. Remember that thing. So it should be there. It should be there. So at the mostly at the right side of that particular corner, you have to write the that particular writer's address. Then after that, below that, you have to write the date. Likewise, here it is the this particular header information is there, and then the date formats you have to consider. Date formats you have to consider. Right. This is the one concept for that particular how they consider that particular heading. Now salutation or greeting. Salutation or of that greeting. Right. So in that salutation that is nothing but what you are doing, or it depends on the relation with that particular reader. Exactly who is there, who in that particular reader is there, what exactly relation with you or with him, your relation with him, depending on that particular salutation it is changes. Now if suppose you are writing the letter to your family, then might be you have to write the salutation as the or greeting as the dear father, my dear mother, dear uncle, like that you have to consider one. If suppose you are writing the letter to the friend, then you have to write dear Sri Desai or dear Sri Patil, like that you have to consider one. If you are considering any business person, then you have to write dear sir or dear ma'am, like that you have to consider one. Right. Now next is the exactly your communication or that body of that particular letter. See, whenever you are writing the letter, at that time you have whatever the things you are considering in the body, it should be in a straightforward. Every sentence it should be related to that particular topic. Not should not be considered in a different manner. You have to write the letter in a different paragraphs, so that every paragraph it is related to each point. Right. In that manner you have to write one. And whenever you are writing this particular letter or that particular body, you have to use simple and direct language, which is understandable one, which is properly readable one, and in a short sentence. It should not be any lengthy sentence. two, three lines sentence should not be there. One and a half line, it is sufficient. Like that. And every point should be in a complete manner. Right? Write the story in a neatly. Not story, that particular points in neatly. Remember the fair, that means use of punctuations, commas, semicolons, full stops in their proper places. You have to take care of all these things. Then only you can write the proper communication body. There should not be any, you can say that lengthy and confused communication in that word. It should be clearly, you can say that, mentioned the thing. Now, last one, the fourth one is the, got the thing in body, you have to consider what the things are there. That means, you have to divide the, whatever the, you want to communicate in a different paragraphs. And each paragraph, it should be having the small sentences, which is understandable by the reader. Okay, grammar, punctuations, whatever the things are there, commas, you have to take care about all the things. Now, fourth, after the body, subscription. Or you can say that, courtesy of living, leave taking. Whenever you are considering, that means your body it is written in a proper manner and you are finishedly you are writing the that particular letter, then you have to courtesy leave, you have to write that particular thing. That means leave taking, you have to write it. Might be some, nowadays it is written as the thanks and regards. Like that it is, they are using the, that particular thing. Or some in the different forms you can consider as or in a normal forms you have to consider you are faithfully, you are sincerely, such things you have to include in a subscription or courteous living taking. At that time you have to write this thanks and regards, and directly you are writing the name. Instead of that, nowadays it is a practice one. But instead of that, if suppose you are writing yours, thanks, it is okay. But yours faithfully, yours sincerely, it is important. This is the main thing. It's again, it is differ. It depends on whether you are writing this particular letter to your friend, family, or your for the business purpose. It depends on that particular thing. Okay, that is the thing. And last one is the fifth point, you have to consider the signature. Why the signature it is necessary? Because that reader should understand who is written this particular, that particular header, it is not sufficient one. Who is written that particular letter? And if suppose you want to with the reference this particular concept, if you want to reply, then whom he have to reply? And for that reason, you have to write the signature. In that signature, that means how it is, it may be there. For example, you are sincerely, and then you have to write the your name. Like that, you have to mention that particular thing. And you have to take care all the, you can see that, strangers. Signature should be clearly written, so that reader may know whom to address in reply. You have to write all the things in that particular letter. It is important one. Right, that thing you have to consider. That prefix should be for the, to the names, it should be written properly. For women, it should be Miss, or it should may be Mrs., or it may be Kumari or Srimati, like that it may be there. So depending on that, you have to clear that particular thing and the that particular signature point. And address on the envelope, it is important now. Because address on the envelope or postal card should be written clearly. Address on the envelope or that particular postal card, should be written in a clearly manner, because you are sending this letter to the that particular person. So it should be in this manner. For example, this address, this is your postage stamp you are writing here, and this is the one example of the format of the your that envelope. So like that we have to write the letter. See, to get the idea about the this particular letters, okay, see, for example, how the letter should be written. See here, get the idea how the letter can be there. Here, this particular your header is there, then your salutation, then your body, then your subscription, then signature. Okay, like that, all the things it should be there. Then only you can say that it is a good letter, right? Such a, and by considering these particular points, the letters are classified in two parts. One is the social letters, and second one is the business letters. Social letters, it is including the friendly letters or notes of invitations. It is the thing. Business letters, it includes the letters for application, letters to the government offices, letters for the newspaper, or related to the business, related to the letters. These things are considered in the this particular thing. I already said that if you are writing the letter to the, your friend, then you can write in that particular friend letter, you can consider the dear. That means friend, it may be for include the friendly letters in the sense of your family and all that thing. So it may be considered dear father, dear mother, or dear friend, dear sister, maybe whatever that thing that should be considered here. And for the business related, dear sir, dear ma'am, like that it is there. Suppose you are writing the letter for the invitation purpose, then you are giving that same concept here. Same things are there. Might be I am having the thing. So same things are there. Same concepts are there. See, invitation here. You have to write this particular header. Then in simple form, today we are having this particular function at in our home at 6 o'clock, and after the 7 onward we are kept dinner. Like that you can see that, and I am inviting to you people for this function. Like that, in 2 or 3 sentences you are considering this invitation. Might be that reader may be accept your invitation, and he is saying that I will be, so he will acceptance letter he will forward you. Reply, like that you can consider one. Right, this is the one format of this particular. You can see that invitation of letter and the acceptance of the letter. So business related letter, again it should be in business related letter you have to take care about the that particular body, because business people are very busy one, and they are not having that much time to read entire letter. So you have to write the letter with considering your business point of view, in the sense for which purpose you are writing this particular letter. Okay, that means you are placing the order and you are asking the that particular person, please deliver as early as possible. You have to write in 2-3 lines with reference of your quotation. I am placing I am writing this particular letter for placing the order, and as early as possible, please deliver the that particular order to me. Like that you can write the letter. But communication body should not be having the much larger one, because they are not having, they will specifically read only the exactly what exactly work you have. Okay, for that reason they are only reading, because they are business people, they are not having that much time. So be care about this thing, and you have to write that particular letter. And address should be in a proper way. You have to mention for the business related letters, you have to write the this particular address in a proper manner, because they are sending the that reply to you people. Right, this is the thing. Normally what happens, I said that heading it should be considered at the right side, but as per the considering the today's tense, that heading it is considered at the left side itself. So as per the today's tense, it is considered one. So just I said that that is the today's trend. You can consider right or left, it is no matter, but remember that everything it should be considered in the later writing. Okay, got these things? So in later writing you have to take care about the what thing you are writing in that particular letter, to whom you are writing that particular letter, whether it is an application, whether it is for business related, official purpose, or all that things you have to take care of, and accordingly you have to write the letters. You have to write the proper, you can see that address on the envelope. It is called as a superscription on the envelope. You have to write the proper address. You have to mention the your name, right, in the signature properly, because by considering that their reader is going to reply you. So all these things you have to note one, and accordingly you have to write the letter. Got this thing? This is the concept of this particular letter writing. If students, if you are having any doubts related to this letter writing, you can ask me anytime. Okay, thank you.